Hey, what's up, guys? Have you recently encountered Windows update failure or an automatic repair boot loop and a blue screen that keeps showing messages like automatic repair or startup repair could not repair your PC? If this is the case, don't worry. In this video, I will show you six safe and simple solutions to fix these errors and get your system back to normal without losing your data. My name is Mazhar, and at Right Solution, I create a tutorial for all you DIY people. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. To troubleshoot and fix Windows update failure and automatic repair boot loop, we need to start our system into Windows recovery environment. There are several ways to access it depending on the state of your system. And if you are in this screen here where it says automatic repair, click on advanced options button and it will take you to the Windows recovery environment. For other scenarios, we use different methods, and as method one, interrupt the normal boot process 3 times. How to do it? Turn on the PC. When the window begins to load, press and hold the power button to force shutdown. Repeat this 3 times, and on the 4th boot, Windows will launch the recovery environment. In the second method, you can use Windows bootable USB. You can create this USB with Windows Media Creation tool. When this USB is ready, boot from this installation USB. On the first screen, select language and keyboard. On the next page, click repair your computer, and this will launch Windows recovery environment for you. If you are using branded system, the method 3 may work for you, as most manufacturers like Dell, HP, Lenovo include recovery options in the BIOS or via a special key during the startup. Common keys for this recovery options are F8, F11, F12 or escape, or maybe you sometime have a special recovery key. These keys may directly boot into recovery tools for you and allow you to access with the Windows recovery system. Let's look into solution one. In this solution, we will use Windows startup repair tool. When you start your system in the recovery environment, click on troubleshoot, and on the next page, click on advanced options. And from here, you can select startup repair. This will diagnose your system for a while and correct if there is any problem. In my case, there is no error, so that's why it says could not repair. From here, you can shut down your PC and restart, or click on the advanced options to go to recovery environment again. In solution 2, we will uninstall recent updates. In the recovery environment, click on troubleshoot and then advanced options. On this page, click on uninstall updates. On the next page, you have 2 options, quality updates and feature updates, where quality update focuses on security patches, bug fixes and performance improvements. And I believe this is the update which could be the problematic. And the second one is the feature updates, which introduces new features, major changes and enhancements for the operating systems. But let's click on to this quality update uninstall. And this confirmation page tells you about if you're running into problems since installing the latest quality updates. Uninstalling might fix them, and this won't affect your personal files, apps or settings. So if you're sure, then click on uninstall quality updates. Let this process finish and then click on done. Restart your system. You could also uninstall feature updates too if you wanted. If your problem is still not solved, then head to the solution 3. In solution 3, we will use a system restore point to revert your computer's system files settings and uninstall programs to a previous working state. Go to the advanced options and this time click on system restore, and this will load this page which will inform you that system restore does not affect any of your documents, pictures or any other personal data. Recently installed programs and drivers might be uninstalled. So click on next. System restore is disabled by default on Windows 11 and I believe in Windows 10 as well. If restore point is enabled in your system, you will find all of them listed with the time and date of creation on this page. Select the restore point of your preference and click on next. On this page, confirm the restore point, and you can scan for the affected programs as well. And if you have changed your password recently, make sure that you create a password reset disk. And when you have all the information, click on finish. And there's a final caution. Once started, system restore cannot be interrupted. Do you want to continue? Click on yes to continue. This process will take a while. Once completed, you will get the confirmation message. Click on restart button to restart. After restarting, key in your password and the system should be running. You see also a confirmation message saying that system restore completed successfully. Let's head to the solution 4. In this solution, we will use Windows Troubleshooter in safe mode. Go to the advanced options and click on startup settings. This page gives you the information about all the options you have. Click on restart to restart your system. After restarting, this page shows all the available options. We want to start in safe mode, so press number 4 on your keyboard for the safe mode. Now your system will restart, and here key in your password and click on this arrow to continue. Now you are logged in into the safe mode. So come here to the search bar and type here system. Now click on this app to open. On this page, in the search bar, type troubleshooter. As you type first three letters, you can see few options had showed up. So select available recommended troubleshooter. On this page, select other troubleshooters. And the next page shows a lot of options here. So just come to these Windows update here and click on run. This will run the diagnostic tool for a while and will recommend you the possible fix. In my case, it found download and install pending updates. So to continue, click on apply this fix. Next page shows that network diagnostic cannot be run in safe mode and we are not actually looking for network problems. So click on next. The tool will continue to detect additional problems. When the troubleshooting completed, it will list all the findings and their status on this page. In our case, it found two problems. The first one says window is in the safe mode and the second one is check for pending updates and its status says fixed. If your problem did not show fixed, click on the no button here. Otherwise, click close and restart your system. That brings us to solution 5. As we are already in the safe mode, let's uninstall troubleshooting updates through the Windows uninstaller. For that, come to the search bar here and type control panel. Now click here to launch this app. In this control panel, look for programs and features and click here to open this app too. On this next page, click on view installed updates. The next page will load all the recent updates here. And to uninstall most recent update, click on uninstall and on this click uninstall again. Now you can see the progress here. When completed, you can close the control panel and restart your system and see if your problem is solved. This brings us to solution 6. If your system is bootable, let's clear the Windows Update cache to resolve the encrypted updates problems. Now come to the search bar and type here CMD and right click here and select run as administrator. And now on this command prompt here, type few commands here. I will copy all these commands into the video's description so you can copy it from there. So type the first command and hit enter. So the first command stops the update service. Now copy and paste the second command and hit enter again. This command will stop background intelligent transfer service. Now copy and paste the third command and hit enter. This command forcefully and silently will delete the entire software distribution folder and all of its content. Now copy and paste the fourth command and hit enter. This command will start Windows Update service. Now copy and paste the fifth and final command and hit enter. This command will restart the background intelligent transfer service. When this is completed, then type exit and get out of this command prompt and now come to the search bar here and type updates and click to open this app here. And now you can just click on this button here to check for updates and you can see it's already searching for the updates. I will fast forward this process. It might will take a little while. It has already found two updates here and it started to install them. One it's already completed and the second one is almost done. So you can just see that it has almost completed it. So our update which was troubling, it's already completed without any trouble.
Thanks for watching, guys. If you think this video was helpful, please give it a thumbs up and I will see you with next video. You have a great day.